Hey guys, how you doing? Andy here. I hope you're all good. Right, I've got a lovely song for you today. This is the Imagine Dragons, Radioactive. It's a great track. There's some very industrial parts to it, but overall you can sort of sing and play this the whole way through, so I thought, well, it was a relevant song. And it seems to be quite popular, so I thought I'd put it up. Now, capo, 7th fret, normal tuning, everybody. Now, there's a part at the beginning. I'm going to be putting the tabs up, sort of over here somewhere, so you can see those. So I've got my middle finger on the 3rd fret. Again, you know, I'm assuming that where the capo is 0, 1, 2, 3. So 2nd finger on the 3rd fret on the B, and then we play the open bottom E, high E rather, play it on the 3rd fret, and then back on the B on 3, and then back on the open E again. And again, you'll be able to see that on the tabs that I'm going to put up. And then that alternates with another phrase, which is... So exactly the same phrase, but you substitute the 3 on the E for the 5 on the E. So, 3 on B... 3 on B, open E, 3 on E... 3 on B, open E, 5 on E. Now, if you heard what I was playing there, the next sort of step up from this really is that you put the bass notes in, which I keep wondering whether to tell you the proper notes or the notes with the capo or whatever else, so I'm not going to talk about notes now. I'm just going to talk about fret numbers, okay, because it could get quite confusing. We'll go into that a little bit later, but if you want to play the slightly more experienced version, 1st finger on the 2nd fret on the D. And what you do is you play those phrases that I just showed you, so... But then you put the additional notes in, so this is the 2nd fret D. Then you play an open G. Open D. Open A. So you get like a... Okay? Now, that's just the intro, guys. The rest of the song, if any of you have ever looked at Wonderwall, this is pretty much a Wonderwall type song, where you've got E minor, G, D, A. Okay, now, I've had a few suggestions about going to strum patterns, and I've often found that it's really difficult to explain strum patterns, because once you start to sort of analyse them too much, you get kind of a bit robotic, and I'm really into people feeling their way through the song, and this is how I would teach my students and anybody else. It's all about you hearing the rhythm. So for me, a lot of the rhythm of this song is... So you've got 5-4, 5-4. But, of course, in between those, you've got some other muted pickings. So we don't just want to go. Because you will sound like a robot. What you want to do is you want to start freeing this hand up, guys, from the elbow. You want to use a light-ish pick. This is a 71, it could be lighter, but I'm holding it light enough, and I'll keep going on about this because it's really, really important. You want to hold it in such a way that actually I can just take that pick out from my hands, but it's in there enough that it's not going to go anywhere. But you know what, guys, every now and again your pick will fly off. So do have spares, maybe put them up here if you're playing acoustic, or if you're on an electric. You know, I frequently, sort of on my tellies and my Strats, I put them inside the, oh my God, I've forgotten the name of that, scratch plate. That's what it's called, scratch plate. Just because they'll go flying off. I mean, at the end of the gig, there are hundreds of picks on the floor when I play. That's another story. So, what you want to do is, you want to have a nice little... As you can tell, I'm just going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, Now, as you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 doesn't match with our 5, 4, 5, 4. Let me play it to you. Probably easier. Sorry, I've just been clearing out my aircon system and I've got a bit of stuff up my nose. Sorry, guys. Playing in the E minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you see what I did there? And I just put my hands across. So I'm playing the chords, and in between, when I don't want the chord to be present and sounding out, I mute on the right, on the left hand, okay? Just put my fingers across. This takes a little bit of time, okay? If you don't do it, you get more of an open, which is fine. You can alternate between that in the chorus and the verses because the chord changes are the same. So I hope you've got the gist of that, guys. As ever, please put me some suggestions about what you'd like. I'll try and add the tabs to this. It creates a bit more work, but I think it's worth it for you guys if you want to do it. And as ever, you know, do contact me. I'm getting a few people contact me for Skype lessons, which is fabulous because, you know, it sort of makes sense of my time a little bit. It means that I can, you know, earn a living as well, guys, which is, you know, what it's all about. I've got a couple of kiddies and stuff, so it's always nice to, you know, meet you guys on the internet and teach you properly, and you might have some ideas, and we go over things in a bit more detail. Please subscribe and please tell your friends about it. It's very important to me, very important. You know, it's nice to know that you guys are watching and listening. Till the next time, keep your suggestions coming in. Guitarworks 1000 on YouTube, info@guitarworks.org.uk, and see you soon. Okay, bye.